life. And so what I did was I basically read through that Gospel of John and I discovered that God is love. I discovered that God came down to earth as a man in the person of Jesus, and Jesus gave his life at the age of 33 to die on a cross, not for himself, not because he was a sinner, not because he had done anything bad, because he himself was perfect and sinless. But what I discovered was he went to the cross for me.
Yes.
And for you and for everyone in the world. He died on the cross, bearing our sin, taking our punishment so that we could be forgiven, so that the gateway to heaven and eternal life would be open. And so today, Jesus is the God of love. He is the God who cares for us. He's the God who died and rose to open the gateway into a better quality life, into a satisfied life, and into a fulfilled life. So today, if you feel dissatisfied with life, if you feel let down, if you feel rejected, if you feel lonely, whatever your condition is today, maybe you're homeless, maybe you're out of work, maybe you're suffering with an illness, I want to tell you today that Jesus offers to you that better and more abundant life. And the way we can receive that is so simple. You know, Jesus made it so simple that he said even a child can receive this. All we need to do is to turn to him, because he's alive. He's all around us. He's here in this street and in this square. And Jesus is here ready to come into our lives.
That's
right. We just need to turn to him and say, Jesus, come into my life.
Yes.
And ask him to forgive us and to change our lives. And he will do exactly that.
Bridget.
He will forgive us. He will come in.
Yes.
And I know this is true because I asked him to do it for me years ago, and he came into my life. He forgave my sins and he's changed my life from being dissatisfied and without purpose and meaning into a life that has joy and peace and meaning and purpose. So today, all you've got to do to receive Jesus is to invite him into your life. Turn away from what you know to be wrong. Believe that Jesus died for you and for your sins, and you can receive forgiveness and peace and eternal life. And as you confess Jesus to be your Savior, he can come in and he will change your life and he will lead you in the path of eternal life. And you can, as you follow him, the life gets better and better. It's like a good wine. The older it gets, the sweeter it becomes and the more tasty it becomes. So Jesus offers to us today the possibility, but you have to make a choice. Today, you can just take that choice. You can make the decision to ask Jesus to come into your life, and you can receive this gift I'm talking about, because it's not found by going to church. It's not found by going on a pilgrimage. It's found as you, in your own heart, just open your heart and turn to God and invite him to forgive you and to come into your life. You see, Jesus is the life. He is full of life. He's full of love. He's full of peace. He's full of meaning and purpose. And so if you want those things in your life, you can receive them by asking Jesus to come in. See, Jesus himself said, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will never go hungry. He who believes in me will never go thirsty. The things of this world, dear friends, will not satisfy us. The things like, you know, food and lovely drinks will not satisfy us. They will satisfy us temporarily. But if you want to be satisfied eternally, you have to receive Jesus, because he is the gift of everlasting and eternal life. And so today, we will be let down if we just put our hope in careers, in marriage, in family, you know, in our government, in the doctors and nurses of this world. You know, we thank God for them, but they will not satisfy you eternally. The only one who can is Jesus, because he is the bread of life. He can give you everlasting life.